morning. Thanks for joining us for another Wednesday Wonderings with Troy's Travel. Thanks for joining us today. Shelo and I have got a few things to go over, but not a whole lot. So we'll just get right started. I want to tell you what I personally right now currently working on is another winter getaway. We have the one to Cancun finished. We have people already reserved on that one for next year. If you're interested in that, be sure and check our catalog down below or one of our links. But I'm working on kind of an ultimate Florida, is maybe the way to say it. So we're going to encompass all the areas of Florida and even head down for a day to the Key West area, Key Largo, the Florida Keys.
Yeah.
So keep an eye on that. I'm hoping to have that accomplished within, I'm setting myself goals here, hopefully the next 2 to 3 weeks max. So do keep an eye open for that. So our shopping trips.
Yep, it's finally ready. We will be rolling our brochure pretty soon.
Actually, I think it's at the bottom.
Oh, that's right. So yeah, check the link below. The three shopping locations that we will be having, which will be Chicago, St. Louis, and Des Moines. And if you have any girlfriends that are wanting to do shopping trips, this would be a good option for you guys. So be sure to check it out.
Right. And it's kind of leaked out a little bit already. We have it in our software system. So there are people already signed up for these shopping tours, which granted they're not until November or December. But again, the motor coach only holds so many and we have to have room for all those packages.
That's right.
I wouldn't hesitate too terribly long. Definitely by summer, I would be making sure your name is on that list if you're wanting to go. So, another one coming up, I guess we haven't talked about a whole lot, maybe, is our Henry Ford in Greenfield Village. That's going in June. Again, this is one my husband keeps saying we got to get to, and yes, he does. So it's ready, and even good time for farmers to be able to get away. So keep that in mind, all you farm guys. And it's actually right up your alley. But there's stuff for the women, too.
Yes, definitely.
Yeah, the first time I went, I was like, but I loved it. Absolutely loved it. And I heard that from many other women, too. So some of the things that you get to see and do in the village, you actually can ride a Model T. You can ride the locomotive. They have one of the largest roundhouses that's working, I think, in the U.S. That's really interesting. But lots of good stuff there. Edison's Lab. Of course, where
the Wright Brothers.
Yeah.
And also, we get to tour Edsel and Eleanor's house. That's the Ford house. And I think that would be one of my favorite on this tour. I've seen pictures. I've never been there. And Carla, you have.
I have. It is beautiful. Yeah. And that is another great special treat. We actually have a meal
there, yep, we're eating dinner there that day. So, yeah.
Yeah, so be sure and check that one out. I think it's one that definitely appeals to both the men and the women. So, also coming up in July is our Wisconsin Door County with the Apostle Islands. That is July 30th through August 5th. Again, Door County is really popular because it's so, to me, it's very charming, laid back, peaceful, just a relaxing area to go to. And then the Apostle Islands, we've had lots of people request that, and so we are including that as well. So
it would be a good trip to definitely make sure you sign up, or if you have any questions, click on the link below or give us a call, and we'll be more than happy to answer any questions you have.
Exactly. And then the Honky Tonk Highway of Nashville, that one is set for the end of August. The thing I love the most about this one, we are staying downtown. You are at the Drury Inn downtown, so you can walk to Lower Broadway anytime you want to.
That would be awesome.
Lower Broadway is a lot of fun, which I'm sure many of you already know. And this one, it's going to include a few other things as far as touring. We'll include both the Country Music Hall of Fame along with the Musicians Hall of Fame. And I just recently, a couple years ago, visited the Musicians Hall of Fame. Shamefully, I didn't realize what it really entailed. I loved it.
What is it?
I actually liked it better than the Country Music Hall of Fame. my husband kind of agreed as well. I mean, we've been to the other one several times, but had not been to that one. So a great little addition. We also do a Raymond Auditorium tour, which is the Mother Church home place of the Grand Ole Opry. But we'll do the Grand Ole Opry as well. That time of the year, though, it's located in a different, it's not in the downtown, it's out by Opryland. So,
and I believe we're also stopping at the Johnny Cash and Patsy's Museum.
Yes, and those are very interesting museums too. So lots to see and do there. Of course, that normal RCA Studio B tour and things like that. But again, we've given you plenty of free time on this tour as well, which I think when you're in Nashville, that's an important thing to do. We have a new tour that we're going to feature next week, and it is Shello's baby. So I'm going to let her tell you all about
Decorah and Lacrosse, a Driftless region. So we'll be focusing on Decorah, Iowa, and Lacrosse, Wisconsin. So if you've ever heard of Driftless region, it's area actually in Wisconsin, Minnesota, Iowa, and it's part of the states that did not have the ice age or
the glaciers
never covered that area. So there are bluffs that you wouldn't think you'd see around Iowa and Wisconsin area. So we will be visiting those places, stopping. One of them would be on our way is the Little Brown Church. So I'm sure a lot of you have heard of it, but it would be, we will be having lunch there on our way.
At the church itself.
The women's group will be preparing our lunch for us for our first day. So that will be one of our stops. And also we'll be doing the fish hatchery. I thought that was really interesting. So this would be for not just for men, obviously for women, but it'd be interesting to see how they rear the trout, as they are the ones that supply it throughout the Iowa area,
right.
as well as Wisconsin. So, and then we'll be doing a trolley tour. I won't give you all the details, but it would include some winery stout, and it would be really cool. So if you watch out for it, it'll come out next week, and we'll have more information on that for you guys.
It's going to be a very scenic one,
yes,
too.
Yes, definitely.
It is amazing how the glaciers, like, knocked everything down, but that area
seems to have, you know, they just missed it.
And I think that's what makes it so very, very pretty, all the peaks and valleys and the bluffs and all the different colors.
Yes.
So,
yeah,
this is definitely one I think is a awesome tour, one you definitely should check out. We have it scheduled for June 26th through the 29th, so... keep an eye out next week for that one. Is there anything else you can think of that we're...
Well, our Samuel is going to be leaving here pretty soon.
Yes.
So for those that are on that trip, we'll be sending out the final letters for them. So we are excited. And hopefully you guys are too that are going to that trip.
I'm very anxious to see and hear the comments when they return, because it's amazing what people have to say about...
Yes.
Seeing this migration.
I agree.
Okay, till next time. Take care. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.